Part three of our GoJacks.com fall camp breakdown takes a look at the running backs with Coach John Johnson. He's in his second year at State, and he's been impressed so far with the level of intensity this group has shown in practice.
Man, I think practice has been going great. I believe the running backs coming out here, man, they got energy, they focus. Excited to be back out here. Man, we got some really mature guys in my group, and those guys are really doing great flying around.
Since Zach Zenner graduated 2 years ago, it's been running back by committee for SDSU. Johnson says to expect more of the same in 2017, with Brady Mangarelli, Isaac Wallace, and Mikey Daniel carrying the pigskin.
Brady Mangarelli, man, you know, he will be a three-year starter. Obviously, man, he's always brought, you know, his A-game every single day. He's not a guy to slack off. He pushed himself really, really hard. So that guy I never have to worry about. Isaac Wallace has really found himself to be comfortable in the offense. He's really doing a nice job of coming out here, staying focused mentally and trying to stay healthy. But, man, I'm really excited to see the things that he's going to do this season just because the practice. Mike Daniels got better in this spring in his carryover during this fall camp.
It's been rather easy to take the running back position for granted on the offense lately. I mean, you have Taron Christian, Jake Winicky, and Dallas Goddard garnering all these headlines. But the running backs are no slouch. SDSU rushers compiled more than 1,500 yards and 12 touchdowns on the ground last season, and their 4.6 yard per carry average was third in the Missouri Valley Football Conference. This year, if opposing defenses continue to focus on the aerial attack, the SDSU running backs could excel.
Obviously, man, Goddard and Winicky, man, phenomenal players, great people. You know, we, as a running back unit, man, we know those guys are great and they're going to get their touches. So as a running back, we have to make sure that we take advantage of every opportunity that's given to us. Whether that's 25 carries a game, whether that's 10 carries a game, we got to make sure we take advantage of every single one of them. Because, you know, people don't look at us as being one of the highlights of this offense, but, you know, lo and behold, we are. You know, we going to hold our ground, and we always come to play at a high level. You know, so we got to make sure we take advantage of every single opportunity.
Johnson says one of the greatest assets of the running backs is how dependable they are, as each guy is eager to learn and get better every day while holding each other accountable.
That close group, you know, they spend time together outside of football, so that carry on into the room as well. They hold each other accountable, and I think that's the biggest thing, man. You know, if somebody mess up, you know, before I can get to that guy, one of the running backs already running to him to make sure he understands that, hey, you got to come back side for this, or you got to do this, you got to do that, you know. So they hold each other accountable, which is good, and having that closeness and that competitiveness in the room, they really push each other to be the best.
In conclusion, we asked Johnson what are the goals he has set for the running backs in 2017.
One of the main goals, want to stay healthy, but obviously, man, we want to make sure we make an impact every single game. You know, we want to score. We want to find the end zone a couple of times a game. We want to make sure that we're doing everything we can to make the first go to Texas. You know, obviously that's the ultimate goal, you know. So as a running back, to do that, we got to come out and be ready to play every single week.